হ্যালো মাই ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্ট, আই এম অরিত্রা চক্রবর্তী, লেকচারার ইন ইলেকট্রিক্যাল ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং অফ শ্রী রামকৃষ্ণ ইনস্টিটিউট অফ সায়েন্স অ্যান্ড টেকনোলজি। টুডে আই এম গোয়িং টু ডিসকাস অ্যাবাউট সার্কিট ইন্টারাপ্টিং ডিভাইস। টুডে ইজ দ্য পার্ট থ্রি লেকচার অফ দ্য সেট টপিক। দ্য ফার্স্ট স্লাইড ইজ আ রিস্ট্রাইকিং অ্যান্ড রিকভারি voltage. So what is restriking voltage? So restriking voltage is the transient voltage appearing across the breaker contacts immediately after the opening of the breaker contacts. It is also called the transient recovery voltage. So when the current across the contact of the circuit breaker is zero, a high frequency transient voltage develop in the whole breaker contact and is produced by the sudden distribution of energy between the electric and magnetic field. This transient voltage is called the restriking voltage, which is restrikes and the arcing phenomena is continuing. And the voltage appears across the breaker contacts at the moment of final current has a serious influence on the arc extinction process. Under the influence of this voltage, the arc tries to restrike, and hence it is named as the restriking voltage. And now, what is recovery voltage? Recovery voltage is nothing but the normal frequency RMS voltage. RMS voltage means the measured voltage. Okay, so RMS voltage that appears across the contacts of the circuit breaker after final arc extinction, it is equal to the system voltage. So that is the recovery voltage. That is the normal system RMS voltage. Now, here you can see the restriking voltage and recovery voltage. If we consider, that is the system voltage and that is the fault current. In case of a circuit breaker, we know in case of a real system, the loads are mainly series RL load or inductive in nature. And when a fault is occurred, if it is a short circuit fault or overcurrent fault due to the short circuit, so what will happen? The resistance is tends to zero or resistance is very low at that time. So at that moment, the circuit act as a purely inductive circuit. So the current lags behind the voltage by 90 degrees. So here you can see that is the system voltage and that is the fault current. So when the value of the fault current at the zero instant, then the separation of fixed contact and moving contact is occurred in case of a circuit breaker. And at that moment, due to this transient, you can see here a high frequency voltage is formed. That is nothing but the restriking voltage. Okay. And which is formed at the time of current zero. Because at that time, the value of the voltage, normal voltage, is at peak value. Because the voltage leads the current by 90 degree angle, and due to this transient, there is a restriking voltage or high frequency transient voltage is occurs. And after clearing the fault, you can see here the normal system voltage, that is the recovery voltage. Okay, so that is the graphical representation of restriking voltage and as well as the recovery voltage. Now, circuit breaker. So, EHV and HV circuit breaker. EHV means extra high voltage and HV means the high voltage. So there are mainly four types of extra high voltage or high voltage circuit breaker. These are as follows. Minimum oil circuit breaker or low oil circuit breaker or MOCB. AR plus circuit breaker or ABCB. Sulfur hexafluoride circuit breaker or SHC circuit breaker. And the last one is the vacuum circuit breaker. So the first one is the minimum oil circuit breaker. So here you can see the image of a minimum oil circuit breaker. That is the top chamber, that is the oil level, that is the fixed contact, this is the gas vent, that is the moving contact. Okay, last one is the drain valve, that is the operating rod, that is the supporting chamber, that is the arc extension device, that is the circuit breaking chamber, and that is the breather. So this minimum oil circuit breaker has three constructional part. One is supporting chamber, one is circuit breaking chamber, another is top chamber. Okay, this is a fixed contact and this is the moving contact. Now we have to discuss the detailed construction of MOCB. So in the previous figure, we can see that the cross section of a single phase minimum oil circuit breaker, the construction is divided into two compartments mainly. Actually there are three compartments. Both the compartments are separated from each other, but both are filled with oil. The upper compartment is namely the circuit breaking component, while the lower one is the supporting compartment, and the above part where no oil is filled, that is the top chamber. The arrangement is made in such that two compartments are separated by a partition and oil from one chamber is prevented from mixing with the other chamber. This arrangement permits two advantages. Firstly, the circuit breaking chamber requires a small volume of oil, which is just enough for arc extinction. In case of minimum oil circuit breaker, the low amount of oil is required for the arc extinction process. So the circuit breaking chamber requires a small volume of oil, and secondly, the amount of oil is replaced is reduced, as the oil in the supporting chamber does not get contaminated by the arc. And the supporting chamber, there is the oil is stored. This oil is not used for arc extinction process, so it is not replaced or reduced. Now at first, the supporting chamber. The supporting chamber is made up of insulating material such as porcelain and is mounted on a metal chamber. So you can see here the supporting chamber. Okay, that is the supporting chamber. It is made by insulating material, and it is the outer section of the minimum oil circuit breaker and mounted on a metal chamber. It is filled with oil and care is taken such that oil is in the circuit breaking component does not get mixed with it. For better insulation, this chamber is filled with oil, but there is no such contact between the oil which is in the circuit breaking chamber and the supporting chamber. So the oil of the supporting chamber is totally isolated from the oil of the circuit breaking chamber. the oil inside the supporting chamber and the annular space formed between the porcelain, the insulation and bakelite paper is employed for insulation purpose only. Okay, so that means this oil is used as an insulating material, and along with it the porcelain and bakelite paper is also used for insulation purpose. Okay, now the next part is the circuit breaking chamber. It is also made up of porcelain enclosure and is mounted on the top of the supporting component. Circuit breaking chamber is filled with oil and has the following three parts. One is the upper and lower fixed contact, moving contact and turbulator. The moving contact is hollow and includes a cylinder which is moves down over a fixed contact. So circuit breaker chamber has mainly three contacts or three parts. One is the fixed contact, one is the moving contact, and one is the turbulator. What is turbulator? So the function of turbulator is to control the arc device. It has both axial and radial vents. The axial venting ensures the interruption of low current, whereas the radial venting helps in the interruption of heavy current. So when the current between the fixed contact and moving contact is higher, then the radial vent is operated, and when the current between these two contact are lower, then the axial vent operated. And that means the axial blast effect is used for lower current and radial blast effect is used for the higher current. And the moving contact is hollow and includes a cylinder which moves down over a fixed piston. Okay, and this moving contact is operating by the help of relay. So that is the circuit breaking chamber. Next, that is the top chamber. The top chamber is made up of metal and is mounted on the circuit breaking chamber. The function of top chamber is that it provides expansion space for the oil in the circuit breaking compartment. This top chamber is not filled with the oil. When the oil is expanded, when the oil is vaporized or when the oil is heated, then it is expanded, and this chamber is used to provide the expansion space of the oil. The top chamber is also provided with a separator which prevents any loss of oil by centrifugal action caused by circuit breaker operating during the fault condition. So that is the top chamber. So that's all the construction of minimum oil circuit breaker. Now we have to discuss about the working principle. So under normal operating condition, the moving contact remains encased with the upper fixed contact. But as soon as the fault occurs on the system, the moving contact is pulled down by the tripping spring and arc is struck between the contacts. So when the fault occurs, then the moving contact pulled from the fixed contact by the help of relay, and the arc is produced between two contacts. The heat of the arc causes vaporization of the oil and produces gases under high pressure. So then the oil has come between the contacts and the oil is vaporized by the heat, and there is a high pressure gas is produced. Due to this action, oil is passed through a central hole in the moving contact and forcing a series of oil through the respective passage of the turbulators. So at that time the volume is increased, that means the density is decreased. So the oil has come from a center hole by the help of turbulator. This causes successively quenching of the arc by the effect of separate stream of oil moving across each section in turn and bearing away its gases. Okay, so When the oil is vaporized, then the gas formed, and gas, the weight of the or volume of the gas is higher than the volume of the oil, so it comes to the upper part of the MOCB. Then there is a empty space is produced, so the oil is charged through a central hole between the contact, okay, and thus the arc is extinguished. So that is the working principle of minimum oil circuit breaker. So minimum amount of oil is needed because there is a forced oil circulation is used, so it is named as the minimum oil circuit breaker. Now the advantages and disadvantages of minimum oil or low oil circuit breaker. So at first, the advantages of minimum oil circuit breaker. It requires small quantity of oil only for arc quenching purpose, since for the insulation purpose solid materials are used. Number two, it requires small space, since the quantity of oil required is less, so space is also less, and a small separation of contact is sufficient to quench the arc. There is a less risk of fire because less oil is used, and maintenance problems are also reduced. Now, the disadvantages of minimum oil circuit breaker. A low oil circuit breaker has the following disadvantage as compared to a bulk oil or high oil circuit breaker. So there is a difficulty of removing the gases from the contact space in time. Okay. When the contact space is formed, then it is very much difficult to remove the vaporized gas of oil from the contact space. Due to the smaller quantity of oil, the degree of carbonization is increased. So that is also a disadvantage. The direct strength of the oil deteriorates rapidly due to high degree of carbonization. So you have to change the oil or replace the oil because the direct strength of the oil is reduced, okay, due to the high degree of carbonization. That's all for today. Thank you.